Big Ben, all 13 and a half tons of it, was cast here at the Whitechapel Bell Foundry in 1858. The foundry was established over five centuries ago, so it's one of the oldest businesses in Britain and has been making bells big and small ever since. These castings will become a set of handbells for export. So what's a bell, any bell, made from?
It's an alloy of copper and tin. Now, both these metals are soft metals, but when they're alloyed, they become hard and brittle. It's a percentage of about 77% copper and 23% tin.
How long has the foundry been here?
Well, it's been in this site since 1738. And prior to that, it was in Aldgate High Street from 1570, and before that, in Aldgate from 1420.
And why did it come to Whitechapel in the first place?
You see, Aldgate was the medieval centre of the London bell founders. And in Aldgate today, you still have a street which runs between Fenchurch and Leadenhall streets by the name of Billiter Street. Well, Billiter is a corruption of a belletier, which was the old English name for bell maker or bell founder.
How is it that a company in the Whitechapel Road receives so many important orders from all over the world?
Well, we've been going for a long time, probably since about 1420 in Aldgate. And so we've become, I suppose, in the particular field of operation, rather well known.
Word's starting to get around. What's the biggest and smallest bell that you've ever made?
Well, Big Ben is the largest bell we've ever made, and that's...
How long can a bell last?
Hundreds of years. We have two bells, for instance, in Westminster Abbey, one cast in 1583 and the other in 1598. And then last year we carried out some work at St Mary's Wimbledon, and there were two bells there which were cast here, one in about 1572 and the other about 1520, and still being used.
What would the price of, a cathedral bell work out?
Well, of course, the cost of a bell is dependent on its size. I mean, I can remember before the last war, I used to buy scrap copper at £35 a ton and tin at £150 to £200 a ton. We now have to pay something like about £900 to £1,000 a ton for copper and about £9,000 a ton for tin.
Well, bell founders are quite uncommon, really. Why is that?
Well, it's a small industry. Back in the 17th century, there were over 30 bell founders in this country, and they've gradually dwindled and dwindled, and now there's only two. And in this century, seven have closed down. And, I suppose bells are expensive articles, and the church doesn't have the money to pay for them.